In this video, we are going to see about the deletion of a node in a singly linked list. In the previous videos, what we have seen is insertion of a node in an existing linked list. Either you want to insert it as a first node or a last node or in the middle. That is what we have seen so far. Now, the same way, how you can delete a node, whether the first node or the last node or the node which is in the middle or intermediate node. Now we'll see how you can insert, how you can delete a first node. So let us imagine this is our linked list. These are all the nodes, and the node consists of two fields, information and the next field where the address of the next node is stored. So using this, you go to the next node till you reach the end of the linked list. The end of the linked list is indicated by the null pointer in the last node. So this is the thing which you have to follow. Now the head is pointing to the first node. So how you can remove the first node? First node means this we want to remove. How you can do? You can do that by writing this address, because this is in it. Now the head has to point to this. So it is simple. In the head node, make this address of the first node to be written. So the head has to be changed to point to the next node. So how you can do? So that's what we are going to see. First, deleting anything, there must be some value. So if you want to delete something, there must be some value. So for that, you have to check whether the node is a first node or there is no any node in that particular list. First you have to check. So that can be done like this. So first you are checking, first you are assigning a temporary node, because I want to remove this node. So for that we are assigning a temporary variable del node, which is of the type node type. Already we have seen node is a structure where it consists of information field and the next field. So this del node is also of the same type, because this we are going to assign as a del node, which is going to be deleted. So now the next point is we have to check whether any node is in the linked list or not. So when a node is empty, when the head is pointing to nothing, that is when the head is null, then you can say the list is empty. So that you are doing. So by checking this, you assume that the list is empty. You found that the list is empty. So if it is not equal to null, then what you have to do? You have to delete the first node. How you can delete the first node? First you assign the del node to the head. The head is pointing to this. So that you are assigning into del node. Now this is a temporary variable. So this you are making this head. Previously this was the head. So that you are assigning into the del node. And then you move the pointer, because head is now this. This head next. So head equal to head next means now it is pointing to the next node. So now 1 or 2. Now this will be written and so now it is pointing here. So now you can write down the, you can print out what data you are deleting by making del node data. By writing this, you'll be able to print what data you are deleting. Then you have to free the memory space occupied by this. So that can be done by this function, building function delete, and you pass that at del node. So now after giving this, executing this statement, this node is no more existing. The memory occupied by that also is released. So the next one is deletion of a last node. So I am going to delete this node G. So how you can do that? So you have to go to the end of the node. Then only you can remove the last node. So how you can identify whether it is a last node? By checking its last, the last node's next field. If it is equal to null, then you can say this is the last node. So first you have to traverse. So while traversing, you should not use the head node, head pointer. You have to assign some temporary variable, temporary pointer variable, or else you will be losing the whole nodes. Because if you move the head next, then you will be losing all these nodes. So in order not to lose that, you assign one more pointer variable. So first what we are doing is, we are assigning some, declaring three temporary pointers. One is del node, which is used to hold the node which you are deleting. then the previous and last, where when you move from here to here, the previous will be this and the current or the last node is this. Then when you move the pointer to this, now the previous will be this and the last will be this. When you move here, the previous will be this and the last will be this. So two pointers you are using in order to move from one node to another. That is because when you remove the last node, you will be removing, but how you can indicate that this will be the last node after your removal of this node, this will become the last node. How you can do? By maintaining the previous pointer, you can say that you can make this to be the null so that this becomes the last node. So in order to do that, you definitely need two more pointers, which is nothing but previous and last. So that is what we are going to see. So after deletion, now the B is the null pointer, and now our linked list looks like this after removal. Suppose I want to, if there is only one node in the linked list, how you are going to manage that? So in that case, this is only one node in our linked list, means after removal, your head will point to null. So that's what we are going to see in our coding. Let us see this function, member function, where here already I told you we are declaring three temporary pointers. So node is del node, previous and last. Previous will point to the previous node and last will point the current node where we are pointing. So here first we are checking whether it is an empty list or not. If it is empty list, then we cannot proceed because the simply it is already empty. So first you are checking if head is equal to null, then simply list is empty and we just close. Then if the next one is, you are checking whether head next is equal to null, which is nothing but if this is the head, only one node. This is the head is pointing to the only one node. Head next means this. If it is equal to null, then only one node. And then what we have to do is, after removal, the head will be made to point to null. So that this condition satisfies. That is, after removal, the list becomes empty. So now you assign that the head, that node, to the del node, this temporary pointer, so that we can remove this node and then we can free the memory space occupied by this node. So we are assigning to the del node. Then else, it is somewhere at the last. That is, our this condition, if there are more nodes, so this also will be there. There are more nodes, four nodes are there. So this we are going to remove. In this condition, how it is going to, how we are going to do? So we are using two pointers. I already told you previous and last. So in order to do that, we are already declared previous and last. Now here in the for loop, we are assigning last to head. So that means now last is made to point, the head pointer is assigned to last. So starting first, initially last is pointing to this. Then here last equal to last next. So we move the pointer last to the next. So that we can reach the end. Head is not moved because if we move the head, we lose the node. So using two pointers, last and previous only, we are going to work out on this linked list. So here, first initially, last is made to point to the head, starting node. And then we move the to the next node by using this statement. And then till what? Till it reaches the end. Till it become last next equal not equal to null, we move. So what happens? We assign this inside the for loop, we have only one this statement. What is that? Previous equal to last. So after movement, last equal to last next, now previous will be the last statement. That is, last is, when last is pointing to this, previous will be this. When last is pointing to this, previous will be this node. And it points to the previous node. So that statement can be achieved by this statement. So when it comes out of the for loop, now last is pointing to the, by this statement, last is pointing to the last node and previous will be pointing to the previous node. Now last is here and previous is here. Now, so when it comes out of the loop, that was the condition. Then we are going to remove the last node. So to del node, we assign the last. Then previous next, What is previous? This is the previous. In null, the next field is made to be a null. So that we are doing it here. Then, so by doing so, we lost the last. So that is why we are writing, we are assigning it to the previous statement. If you interchange this, then you will not get the last also. So this the strict order has to be formed. Before removal, you have to assign it to a temporary pointer, and then you can make that to be the previous next to be null. Then finally, what you are doing is, here just you are printing, and then here del node. Last statement is see here, the last statement is del node is there, but it is not visible here. So in this, the last statement is del node. I'll show you here. See here, delete del node. So now the node is, after execution of the statement, the node will be deleted. Now the next one is